Welcome back. This is Mr. Hassan's Math Channel, and I'm now doing or answering question number 3 from the International A Level Pure Mathematics P4 June-October 2020 paper. And this question here is about a region R which is bounded by the curve y equals e to the power of 0.5x minus 2, the x-axis and the y-axis. And the region R is rotated 360 degrees about the x-axis to form a solid of revolution. Show that the volume of this solid can be written in the form A ln 2 plus B, where A and B are constants to be found. Okay, so when we take a area like this and we rotate it around the x-axis 360 degrees, we are forming what's called a volume of revolution. Okay, I'll try to draw it here. But basically what we do is we take a thin strip of this. It's not very thin, is it? Well, that's about the thin I can draw it here. We take a thin strip of this area, like really thin strip. I'll just draw it like that, like a line. Okay, so this thin strip of this, it's like a rectangle. Doesn't look like a good rectangle, but anyway. So we take this and we rotate it around the x-axis. Okay, so it forms like a cylinder. Okay, it forms like a cylinder of radius of this distance here. Now this distance here is basically the y value of that point. Okay, so it's like this is the radius is y, and the thickness of this strip. The thickness of this strip is like the width of this rectangle. Okay, so you can think of it as the width of this rectangle. Now that is given a distance or thickness dx. So we know that the volume of a cylinder is given by pi r squared h, which is the area of the cross section, which is like that circle, times h, the thickness of the cylinder. So we can say that the volume of this is going to be given by pi times y squared times the thickness, which is dx. Now if I was to take the sum of all of the cylinders from this point here to this point here, let's call this point A, from 0 to A, then the volume of that would be given by the integral between 0 and A of pi y squared dx. That will give me the volume of all those cylinders added together. That's what you do when you integrate. You're basically finding these thin little slices and adding those volumes together. Okay, so that's what we have to do. The volume of revolution is always given by taking the equation, which is y equals e to the power of 0.5 minus 2. So you have y equals e to the power of 0.5 x minus 2. Okay, and the volume of revolution is given by, oops, what happened there? The volume of revolution is given by write it over here, sorry, is given by, as we said, the integral of pi times y squared dx between the limits 0 and a. Okay, and a in this case is the point where it hits the x-axis. Okay, so now, so we need to find the point a. So I'm going to show some of the working up here so we can see what's going on. So to find what a is, x equals a on, that's when it's on the x-axis, sorry. X equals a on the x-axis, as we can see, so that's when y equals 0. So if we equate this to 0, e to the power of, let's say, a half x minus 2 equals 0. So e to the power of a half x equals 2. So we can find what x is by taking the ln of both sides. So we're going to have a half x equals ln 2, so x equals 2 ln 2. So this is that point here, 2 ln 2. So that's where it hits the x-axis, 2 ln 2. So I know my limits are, so I can rewrite this that the volume of revolution is going to be given by, I can take the pi out here because it's a constant, and I'm going to take y squared, which is e to the power of 0.5x minus 2 squared, and integrate that with respect to x between the limits of 0 and 2 ln 2, which is like ln 4. just lin 4. Okay, in fact, I'll leave it as 2 lin 2. Why? Because you see the question, the answer here in the form A lin 2. So it might be wiser to leave it as 2 lin 2 for now. Okay, 2 lin 2, not 4. Okay, 2 lin 2. All right, so now, this now will tell us the volume of this area when you rotate it round the x-axis between these two points. Will tell us the volume of that shape. Okay, so now what we're going to do here is we're going to integrate this. Before we can integrate this, we have to get it ready for integration. And it's not ready for integration the way it looks now, because we don't have outside it something which is the differential of what's inside. So we have to square this, basically. Now, so you're going to have pi times the integral between 0 and 2 lin 2 of this. Now, you're going to square the first term. Now, e to the power of a half x squared, you multiply the powers, and 2 times a half is 1, so this is going to give you e to the power of x. And then you're going to have minus, and you're going to have this times this doubled, so it's going to be minus 4 times e to the power of, I prefer to write a half x myself, and then I'm going to have at the end plus 4. Now, each of these terms we are able to integrate. We can integrate each of these terms. There's no problem with integrating them, so let's go ahead and integrate each of these terms. So we can say that the volume is equal to, now I can put my square bracket when I integrate, don't forget the pi. Okay, so don't forget the pi. Very important, you're going to have pi times, you're going to have e to the power of x when you integrate it stays the same. And you're going to have minus 4 times, and now this is e to the power of a half x stays the same, but then you divide by the differential of what's inside the function, which you have to divide by a half. So I'll just write it like this, divided by a half, plus 4x, and my limits are 0 and 2 lin 2. Okay, so now this is going to give me pi times, I have e to the power of x, this is 4 divided by a half, which is 8, so minus 8 e to the power of a half x plus 4x. Now I'm ready to put my limits inside here. So that's going to give me pi times, I'll have e to the power of 2 lin 2, minus 8 times e to the power of a half times 2 lin 2, which is lin 2. Okay, and I'll have plus 4 times 2 lin 2. Minus, and then I'm going to have, let me do it like this. Just to make it a bit clearer, I'll put pi, because pi is multiplying all of it. I've got my big bracket, then I have this, and minus this when I put 0 in. Now don't always think putting 0 in will make things 0. They won't, because you've got e to the power of 0, which is 1. Minus 8 e to the power of 0, that's going to give you an 8. Plus 4 times 0, well, that will give you 0, but just that part will be 0, not the whole thing. So you've got to be careful about that. Now we can try to simplify this. I might have to go to the next page. Let's just see what we get. Here we have pi, and here this is e to the power of 2 lin 2. These are basically, you could say, inverses of each other. Okay, so e to the power of 2 lin 2 will just give you 2 lin 2. They can cancel each other out. In fact, it's just going to give you 4, actually. This is going to give you 4. So 2 lin 2 is the same as e to the power of lin 4. So you're going to end up getting 4 because they cancel each other out. So in fact, it would have been better for me to write this as lin 4. Okay, so I'm just writing this as lin 4 instead of 2 lin 2. That's going to give me 4. And this is going to give me 8 times... This is going to e to the power of lin 2 is going to give me 2. And I'm going to have plus 8 lin 2. Okay, and then from that I've got to take away. This is going to give me 1 minus 8 plus 0. Okay, now just a little e lin 4. Like, so supposing I said, for example, p equals e lin 4. And I wanted to prove that this is equal to 4. Okay, p is equal to e lin 4. So what I can do is I can take the lin of both sides. Okay, in which case I'm going to get lin p equals If I take ln of both sides, I'll get ln of e to the power of ln 4. So I have ln p, okay, I'll just write it here, ln p is going to be ln 4 times ln e. Ln e is equal to 1. So you say ln p equals ln 4, so p equals 4. So you can show that p is equal to 4. So you can show that this thing is equal to p, so this thing is equal to 4. Basically, when you put a function inside its inverse, they cancel each other out. So f in composite with the inverse of f of x gives you x. It just, they cancel each other out and you're left with just the x. So this is like putting the ln of something and e to the power of something are basically inverses of each other. So you, it's like you're putting 4 inside a function and inside is inverse, so they cancel each other out, so you're left with 4. That's how that works, and this is why this becomes e ln 2 becomes a 2. So now we are left with pi times, and you got 4 minus 16. Okay, 4 minus 16, which is minus 12, plus 8 ln 2. And you're going to have minus 7, which is plus 7. 1 minus 8 is minus 7. So now you end up with pi times, you're going to have minus 12 plus 7, which is minus 5. So you have 8 ln 2 minus 5. And they said give the answer in the form of a ln 2 plus b. So we can say 8 pi ln 2 minus 5 pi. So that's the volume, and that's in, you know, units cubed. Okay, so 8 pi ln 2 minus 5 pi is the answer in the form that they require. And we can say a is equal to 8 pi, and b is equal to minus 5 pi. And there's the answer to this question. Question number, I think it was 3 from this paper. And other questions that are related to volume of revolutions will be found in this playlist over here. That should appear here soon. On the top above it should be the playlist for this paper, for questions from this particular paper. So in the middle here you'll have a icon which takes you to subscribes you to my channel, and on the top here you will have a link to another P4 paper. Thank you for watching. I hope that was clear, and I hope to see you soon.